Indonesia, Malaysia, yeah, Thailand, they master this hero. So I think we're in for a show, man.
Yeah, I mean, admittedly, you're right. It's not a part of the meta in the Philippines, but even in the Invitational, I believe this is the first time we've seen Roger. Maybe the second time overall, but nonetheless, this is going to be both teams learning from their game one, and Thailand, luckily, no longer saying no to a tank. They pick up the Hylos, and the Vietnam, they're like, you know what, we'll show you how to use the jawhead. Alright? we'll pick up the jawhead ourselves, and since you let go of the Thams, we're gonna take it as well. Manjin, gotta ask you before we go into the game, is it gonna be a sweep? I feel like it is.
Yeah, me too.
Vietnam did not pull any punches, man. This draft is just as waterproof, as foolproof as it could be. Waterproof, what? As foolproof as it can be.
You know what? I think it's a free game for the Ling. Because one way to answer the Ling, first of all, you gotta have sustain. You gotta survive the Tempest of Blades, the ultimate, and then you really need to have a single target lockdown. And what they have is the tether on the string, the puppets on a string, and the Link can easily just pinch poise his way and cut that string out. He's like Justin Timberlake. Well, it's gonna be like Justin Timberlake from Bye Bye Bye, right? Just running away from the girl who's just like controlling him with the string. It's a total victory for me, for team Vietnam. But who knows? Who knows, man? We're just casters, so we shall see. We shall see what can Team Thailand bring to the table.
So far, Team Thailand, they have more than just, I believe, the Pepatana string. There is the order on the Hylos, so maybe they can stun the Ling if they can catch him off. But Vietnam, though, they look like they want to secure the purple first for Brawly, and they'll take this Little Wonder and go for the orange, which I think is just enough time for him to reach level 4. And then from there, I think it's hunting season. You just go from there, man. Who's your best target here for on the side of Team Thailand? I believe. Wait up. Hold up. I don't think Team Thailand is just going to lay down and take this, man. Look at this. Yeah. Hack looking low already.
T-Max, but where's your burst, though? Ooh, Lois was kind of late in there. He's late in the party, but at least they put up, they showed up and... probably they scared Team Vietnam away, but
Brawly was too far. Brawly was too far.
Yeah, Brawly was too far. But there you go. There's a counterplay coming in from the bouncing ball at Tyrant's Revenge. But the Revitalize is there to save Easy, of course. Plus, there you go. Wolverine is in town. Lois scratching the life out of Hyde. But on you go, Brawly with a counter engage. 1-1.
That was perfect. I think he reached level 4 at the perfect time. If Team Thailand did not invade the orange, I think Brawly would have been level 4 much, much sooner, able to threaten that three-man coalition from Team Thailand. But nonetheless, great start for Team Thailand. I gotta give him that, especially with the revitalize from from Izzy. Izzy just popped in at the right time, at the right place, especially when Vietnam said, okay, we'll take it. Oh no, we can't! So they lost Hyde along the process, and this is a good start for Team Thailand, but far from a victory just yet. Far from evening it out.
You know what? The revitalize plus the love waves, the love taps from Mizzy Mink is just a huge way for you to survive the Ling damage. So yeah, props to Team Thailand for evening up this the score here at the first 3 minutes mark. I think, Leo, the next fight will be now up because the Ling is now lurking towards the mid. But there you go. Esmeralda rotating in the mid lane, set, making a play, making out of something, out of nothing. And it will give Team Thailand this free turtle. Mm-hmm. And there's gonna be no answer for Team Vietnam.
Great conversion, but I'm starting to get worried here for Hyde. 0-2-1. Maybe one more free kill here. Not gonna be a good look for the Selena. Down goes Trung Trinh. This is a big fight here. Dropping the glorious pathway is Izzy. And it seems like the linchpin of the strategy for Team Thailand, at least in the early game, is easy. It's a high loss. He's doing so much work here for Team Thailand.
Yeah, man. It's like the best thing you got, because you have a glorious pathway. It enables all of your heroes. It enables the Roger too, right? Because if you're gonna think about it, the Ling is kind of like an answer to the Roger, because the Roger cannot really like use his skills against the Ling. But every time you have the glorious pathway with you, the Roger can maneuver his way towards the Ling. So yeah, man, this is looking good for Team Thailand. And look at this, I think they really want to team fight, because all of them, they're now building cooldown reductions.
And I think cooldown reductions are going to be key. That's the counter to the counter punch play, right?
Yeah.
You want to time out your opponent's ults, but what if they're able to sustain long enough, which I think Team Thailand is willing to go and do, and then just wait for the cooldown. But look at this now, Seth here in trouble. There's the ejector. But then again, this is Seth, my friends. This is an Esmeralda. Drep Trai is in trouble. Throng Trinh as well, bouncing his way out of here. Glorious Pathway set down like a carpet into the home of Team Thailand. And just like that, they disengage. Team Vietnam not willing to take this fight. And even Lois is bullying Broly. Broly can't fight back, not just yet.
Yeah, man. I think the plan here for Team Thailand is just like San Antonio's first. Defense is the best offense. Team Vietnam, they're just putting everything there. They're just throwing everything in the kitchen sink. But still, they don't get the damage that they wanted. Team Thailand just surviving the ganks coming in from Team Vietnam. And with this Esmeralda and Angela pick, I think it made sense why they prioritized the Angela, Leo. Like, we've seen it three times in the top lane where Broly, he was trying to, like, make a play. He was trying to gank too, but man, Esmeralda with two kills, an avarice with that, the avarice as a unit of cooldown, a cooldown reduction as well. With his first item, it gave him the time to spam the Stardust Dance, to spam the Shield Steal, and with that, I think Team Thailand slowly like taking this game away.
And again, you see where Vietnam is finding their comeback, where they're making the most of it, is with T-Max. T-Max is having an okay time. He's pushing down bottom. And now look at this. Hack gets there the Angela in him. Mizzy Mink just making this Uranus a little tougher than usual. Down goes T-Max. Surprisingly, it's the Thams that goes down first. Throng Trinh bouncing ball away. And again, this is another fight that Vietnam refuses to take. Team Thailand is setting the pace here, and it's looking like it's their game this time. Manjin, could this possibly be Vietnam's first defeat?
Final, I'm having high hopes, man. Hack ain't going back, because he has the Angela passive, the global presence of this Angela, man. And now we're now seeing the clash in the mid lane. There's no time switch, but bouncing ball out with the flicker. Meanwhile, from behind, Seth is here pumping up her ultimate, but he's not gonna pop it, as one hero will fall down for Team Vietnam. Nice pick up there coming in from Lois. The werewolf is now in town, and he is slaughtering the sheeps from this Team Vietnam. Team Thailand 3-6, not even popping a sweat, Leo.
No, not even. I mean, this is Team Vietnam, so we do know that VEC Fantasy Main is a great team, dominant in the first 2 days of the Invitational, but possibly that break kind of changed the way that their conditioning has gone, right? Maybe that one-day break kind of changed their momentum, but nonetheless, game one, totally theirs. But what did Team Thailand eat between what did they do between that break going in, back into the lobby, that made them perform this way? Was it the Roger? Was it the Angela? Man, we did predict a two game series, for Vietnam, you're right, but this team fight breaking out of nowhere, what a jump and a kill onto T-Max. There's an arrow, Hyde missing his mark. Lois, they have the Angela in them. Mizzy Mink, hold up. Lois gets popped in by Drep Trai. There you go. The kill by the Ling. Broly finally finding some redemption. But Throng Trinh might be paying the price. His teammate's sins toward Team Thailand is going to haunt him. And just like that, this tower might just go down, and Hack and Seth are none the wiser to get out of there and take what they can. Manjin, Man. Team Vietnam fighting back, but Thailand says, hey, this is our game, all right? Let us have this one.
Yeah, I think Seth is on an anime mode right now, man. You know what? You know in the anime episodes where the protagonist is like with glasses and he like looks down with her bangs or with his bangs and the glasses just like lightens up? This is Seth right now for Team Thailand. He's carrying the team from being swept. And
oh,
man,
yeah.
Oh, with the sustain, he has the sustain from the Angela. He's having help from Hack too. This is his game for the taking. And Broly, yes, that was a perfect entrance coming in from him. He gets the Roger. He gets heroes. But man, the sustain from Thailand is just too much for Team Vietnam to handle.
Yeah, and yeah. I think as a sidekick, you know, like the secondary protagonist, like the Vegeta to Seth's Goku, Izzy here is also carrying quite the weight, man. 1-1-6, and every single team fight that the Hylos is present, as soon as he goes down, drops the Revitalize, drops the Glorious Pathway. Vietnam is like, nope, we don't want to fight that. Let's not stay here. We'll time it out. And again, looking at the items now, Dominance Ice on our friend here, Izzy. It's so good. There's so much physical damage on the side of Team Vietnam that every single time that they attack him, DPS goes down. It's a great start here. And I think we're going into the mid game, almost into the late. And looking at the items, man, this Ling, to be fair, is still getting some farm. Tung Broly here, 8,000, still way ahead of anything that Team Thailand brings to the table. So you can imagine how much is getting funneled to him. They are down 6,000 gold, but he's still getting farm.
Still getting farmed. And and again, Team Thailand, they need to be careful. Of course, Broly is still your final boss to deal with.
The purest Saiyan.
The purest Saiyan. Yeah, right? No pun intended, guys. Yeah, but again, 5-11. We shall see, because man, Team Thailand, they're building anti-physical damage items. I've seen the Dominance Ice and the Antikiras, but of course, we shall talk about that later, because we're going to have a fight here in the mid lane from 7 to 2, and they will get T-Max. T-Max is down for the count, 26 seconds to the death timer, and there you go, that's the push from Lois. An arrow will connect, but is it going to be enough? No, it's not. Yes, it is, but that will be the Hylos down. That is a tank, ladies and gentlemen. Hack ain't going back. The arrow will connect, the ejector to the fountain, but it's okay. That's just a giveaway kill. Team Thailand, is this the final hurrah, Leo? Two heroes are still alive for Team Vietnam. Lois and Seth, they want to end the base. We don't want to go down 0-2. We want a victory. There you go. Seth, Team Thailand on Super Saiyan mode, takes